Okay. Show me.
Show me indeed. I've got me a brand new diatone here, the L5, their latest new quadcopter. So this is a lightweight lightweight 5-inch quadcopter for endurance, maybe long range. And again, I'm very excited about this quadcopter. I'm anxious to fly it. But first, we're gonna take a look at the quadcopter, what you get, of course. And actually, I got me two of those. Yeah, they are different. I'll show you both the differences, at least in this video. And in case you're wondering whether I buy everything myself or get everything sent for free, the right one over here, one of them is sent by Diatone for free, and the other one I bought myself. But wait, it gets worse. I got me a third one. Yeah, I also bought me this one myself. This is a frame kit, so I'll be doing a separate video, a frame review of this one, and I'll be building it. I'm not sure what components I'll use yet, but again, I'll be doing a frame review of this one as well. In this video, I'm obviously going to show you these quadcopters. I'm going to show you what you get with the quadcopters, and we'll fly them. Mostly, yeah, that'll be the proof in the pudding, of course. And after this video, I'll see whether I need to tune these. And if I do, I'll provide you with a tune. So this, what you see here, is actually a 6S version and a 4S version. And I'll have a look whether I need to tune them. The 4S version, I'll fly with a lithium ion back for endurance, right? And I suspect that it'll need some kind of tune. But I'll get back to you in a separate video on the tune for both of these quadcopters. Let's have a look at the quadcopters. So guys, what you see here is the 6S version again, and here is the 4S version. That's not the only difference though. This is a DJI digital version with a Caddx Nebula Pro camera. And this one over here is an analog version. Let me see. Yeah, so other than that, yeah, this is more like a production version. You see some labeling on this one, and yeah, that's it basically. You can always recognize the digital versions from Diatone from their black antenna, and this is white antenna, the analog version. And they both have a GPS antenna, and yeah, so you know what, let's have a look at all these warning labels. Actually, there are a lot of labels on this one, and again, this one is a production version, and this is kind of like a pre-production sample, I guess. That's why it doesn't have all the labeling on it. Okay, so the first labels you noticed were these on the motors. First time I see those. Apparently people have been putting the wrong propeller on the wrong motor. Or maybe this is because the DJI Digital FPV drone, that one DJI drone, has directions on what propeller to do where, or to mount where. Okay, so yeah, clockwise propellers go here and here, and counterclockwise propellers go there and there. Basically, Betaflight stock directions, yeah. And then there's this label on the XT60. 4S LiPo, 6S LiPo, recommended battery size. Okay. Huh. Surely you know what you ordered, right? There's no I'm not sure. Maybe they meant to cross out 4S or 6S, but it didn't happen. Yeah, so the intent was there. Execution, Okay, when adjusting battery placement, please put the battery over the plus mark on the label for accurate center of gravity. And there's you might not be able to see that, but there's a plus over here. Okay. Yeah, so yeah, okay, that does actually make sense. If you put your battery out of alignment, or too far forward or too far backwards, two of your motors will struggle more and the other motors will hardly do anything. And not only that, your PID tune will be off. So checking the balance of your quadcopter, checking if the center of balance is more or less in between the back motors and the front motors. And yeah, that's where the plus actually is. So that does make sense, to at least pay some attention to the center of gravity after placing the battery on your quadcopter. So, good point. And apparently people have been doing that wrong, maybe burning out an ESC in the process. I don't know, but Ditone must have had a reason for this label, I'd say. Then there's one more label, and it actually goes, it's starts here and it then goes around this side and it ends over here. So let's see what it says. Can I rip it out? Yeah, okay. Okie dokie. That is more than interesting. For the best flying experience, please do not adjust stock PID settings. When changing settings, please remove propellers. Yeah. Okay, basically what this says is that if you are working on your quadcopter settings, remove the propellers for safety. Obviously, once you want to test those settings, those new settings, you will have to put the propellers back on, right? There's no testing without propellers. Okay, so for best flying experience, please do not adjust stock PID settings. Okay, I guess they are very confident in their setup. Interesting. Okay, so we'll put that to the test. So I'll fly this 4S version first on a 1300 4S, I guess. Yeah. Okay, interesting. Very interesting. And again, my pre-production sample, this digital version, has none of these labels. Okay, so there's one more difference between my quadcopters here, my L5s. One has the white action camera mount. If you are familiar with Ditone quadcopters, you have seen these camera mounts, right? The white camera mounts. A lot of their quadcopters come with these. The production version has a yellow one. And I've asked Ditone about this, what's the difference? The plastics are different. This one is a little less brittle, less stiff. It is a little more flexible. People have been breaking these camera mounts. So I guess, this one, I'm not sure how flexible. It's not like a TPU, it's not rubbery, but apparently it won't snap as quickly. Slightly more flexible. So that's one of the differences. And if you order this quadcopter, you will get it in yellow. A slightly more flexible camera mount. And now that we're at it, let's see what you actually get with these quadcopters. So you get an action cam mount, appropriate for or usable for the GoPro standard quick mount system. Then you get an USB cable. USB-C cable, I'm not sure why. It's a nice gesture, I guess, but most people will have a USB cable, I guess. Yeah, so these quadcopters both have USB-C connectors on the flight controller, so, and the digital version obviously has a USB-C connector on that Vista air unit thing. So you get this cable, I'm not sure why, again. Do you not have a USB-C cable? Let me know in the comment section below. I would have rather had a second set of propellers, for instance. But, it's a nice gesture. Then we have ourselves a receiver connector kit, if you will. And these come with a lot of Ditone quadcopters. So you got one cable for an RXSR receiver, no soldering required. So it has a plug on either end. And you simply plug it into the quadcopter and your receiver, and that's it. And the other cable has not a connector on the other side, so no connector on the other side, and you'll have to solder that up to any receiver you'd want, an S-Bus receiver, I-Bus receiver, right? Crossfire, obviously, that'll work. And this easiest way to set up a receiver, I guess. Then we got some documentation. Maybe an exploded view of the frame. Yeah, okay. I'm not sure what it'll look like on camera, but these are all the parts for the frame if you want to replace things. And here is an exploded view of the frame if you want to work on your quadcopter. Might come in handy if you're new to quadcopters. Then we get one set of propellers, and these are Gemfans, SL5125s. And that's interesting because I recently built me a lightweight 5-inch quadcopter myself, and I use the same propellers. These work. Very nice propellers. But you only get one set. And that's actually usually the case in a Titan quadcopter. So one set of propellers. Then we get a care package with all kinds of stuff. Let's have a quick look what's in this bag. You get a couple of zip ties. Very nice. You don't even really need zip ties for this quadcopter, so it's definitely always handy to have some around. So thank you very much. You get antenna tubes. And yeah, if you want to use your own receiver, obviously the digital version already has that air unit, that KEDEX VISA air unit, which is a receiver in itself. But most people will use a separate receiver, I guess. So antenna tubes for that. Thank you very much. Then you got two luxurious, actually, battery straps. Yeah. I'm not sure what these will look like on camera, but these are the most luxurious battery straps I've ever seen with a Diatone. Very, very nice. Yeah, anti-slip, of course, metal buckle. Very nice. They are a bit thick, but that won't be a problem on this quadcopter at all. These are very durable. Very, very nice. Yeah, I like seeing that. Better straps than on the previous Diatones. Okay, and an anti-slip mat for your battery as well. A two-piece slip mat. Then we've got... Okay, this is an extra, not needed at all. These are platforms to mount things in your quadcopter. A 20 by 20 from the looks of it, and a 16 by 16. Yeah. These are ready to fly or plug and fly quadcopters. You won't be needing these, but maybe if you want to add something to the quadcopter, definitely nice. Then we've got some tape, and this is, I'm not completely sure, Captain Tape? I'm not completely sure of the name. I usually use this kind of tape to wrap around the motor wires, and the Diatone usually uses zip ties. But if you don't like that, you can use this tape for that. First time I think I see that come with a Diatone quadcopter. Definitely a bonus. They didn't have to. It's not needed, so thank you very much. Nice, nice gesture, I guess. Okay, caps for the antenna tubes. Rubber caps, thank you very much. And usually with any Diatone quadcopter you get all kinds of spare screws. So, and that's the case here as well. All kinds of spare screws for the frame and some nuts. Those are all extras, very, very nice. And you got some screws to mount your propeller. So those aren't extra, but you'll definitely need those. And this cable, I'm not completely sure. This looks to be a cable for an FPV camera. I'm sure it's a spare cable, but I'm not completely sure why they've added it. Spare cable, okay. Yeah, thank you very much. Why not? A spare cable. And then there's this cable as well. This is a spare cable. And it did come with my analog version, but this is a cable to hook up a DJI digital setup. Yeah, the flight controller, you see that in a minute, has a port for your DJI digital setup. And this is a cable for that. So it's not really a spare, I guess, because it came with an analog version. And this is a spare. This is this goes in the back of your quadcopter. It's a receiver mount, I guess. Or, yeah, antenna mount. Okay, but it's a spare. It's already in the frame. With that all said and done, I could talk for hours probably about these quadcopters or any quadcopters, but let's do some flying first, right? And I'll be flying the 6S version on this CNHL 850 milliamp hour 6S battery. Diatone does advise or suggest a bigger LiPo at 1050, so a 1050 milliamp hour. To me, this is a light quadcopter, right? So I don't want to weigh it down with a huge battery. The quadcopter will fly probably great with a huge battery, but I want to keep it light. 850 milliamp hour is what I use on my self-built 5-inch lightweight quadcopter. So yeah, with that said, let's do a line of sight test flight, why not? And then do some FPV flying as well. And we'll see what it flies like, and also if the GPS actually works. After that, we'll get back to the studio and then I'll give you some closing thoughts and some in-depth views and how to connect things and such. And yeah, okay, but let's do some flying first. Here we go.
Alrighty guys, maiden line of sight test flight with the Diatom L5-6S digital version. And yeah, what can I say? In case you're wondering whether these kinds of videos on my channel are actually the maiden flights, they are. I've done a short test hover, so I know it takes off. Other than that, I know nothing. Nothing at all. Yeah, okay, let's do some flying. Here we go. It arms. So 850 milliamp hour 6S CNHL LiPo, and it is windy, by the way, windier than I'd want to fly a quadcopter like this, a lightweight. So let's see how it handles itself. So far, not bad at all. It might look sunny, but it's been raining all days. All days? Yeah, that also. No, it's been raining all day, rather. It's pretty cold and nasty wind. 4x4 wind. But not bad at all so far. Pretty nice. Okay, it does flips, and it's moderately easy to do a line of sight flying with it, partly because of that big antenna at the rear, I guess. Not bad at all. I haven't heard weird oscillations, tuning things. It flies like on rails, very controllable despite the wind. Hopefully you can actually hear what I'm saying because of the wind. Yeah, very easily controllable. Nice. Pretty silent. You can probably hear it a little bit in the video, but it's definitely not a noisy quadcopter. So in case you are looking for something not to disturb other people, this might be the ticket. Okay, so a punch out. These aren't monstrously powerful quadcopters, right? But that wasn't bad. But yeah, again, these quadcopters aren't designed for out and out power. Long range FPV cruisers with moderate freestyle capabilities, I'd call these kinds of quadcopters. I suspect it will be pretty fast, actually. Can't wait to FPV fly it. So, yeah, you know what? Very, very nice. This is completely bone stock. I haven't tuned any, touched any setting other than my rates. Yeah, and my flight modes. Very, very nice. Cool. Successful maiden. I am happy. Oops. What was that? Air mode. An air mode jump. The quadcopter was so happy it flew. It jumped for joy. Yeah, okay. So, successful maiden. Let's do some FPV flying with it. Here we go. So, FPV maiden for the Diatom L5, and I've had it armed for about 1.5 minutes. I've got 10 satellites and I've got GPS log. Yay! Okay, success. That's 11 satellites. Very nice. Okay, let's. Oops. Righty. Now, I should say, in case you haven't seen my line of sight maiden, it is very, very windy. In fact, I'd be surprised if you can actually hear me well enough. So I think the quadcopter will bobble around a little bit because of the wind. In fact, I can see it wobble around a little. Now also, this is a prototype of the L5. And therefore, it doesn't have the Nebula Pro camera, but the Nebula. So, but it actually looks pretty good somehow. That's weird. Oh, I'm in a public channel. Okay, so 25 megabits. That's not a huge thing for a first test flight. It's too windy anyway. But the image actually, you tell me in the comment section below what you think of this recording. But regardless of that, this is again a prototype. The production versions will come with the Nebula Pro. Yeah, too bad it's this windy. This is not really representative of what the quad can do. So hopefully I'll be able to show you some flight footage in the near future without all this wind. Let's fly a little bit further, even though I'm at a public channel, 25 megabits. Shouldn't be a problem, right? Okay, so I can't really tell you much about what it flies like. Other than it's pretty silent. And the GPS setup actually works this time. Flawlessly. 17 satellites by now, so I am very happy to see that. You probably know of the debacle with the 4-inch quadcopters. Looks like they have been solved. And I'll talk more about that on the bench in a minute, in the studio. Why, at least I think, the GPS setup is better. But yeah, shame it's this windy. I am very glad though that the FPV footage looks this good, surprisingly good, and that the GPS setup works. Okay, so enough. Yeah. Enough of a wobbly flight. I don't think this is the PID tune we see here. And I'm not sure what it looks like to you, but it should look a little bit wobbly. Yeah. Amp draw, less around 3 amps. 4 amps. Yeah, you will definitely be able to fly very, very long. And I'm flying on an 850. Okie dokie, let's get back to the studio and I'll give you my closing thoughts and I'll show you the inners and some tech specs and blah de blah. Yeah.
So guys, that looked a little bit dramatic maybe, not what I was expecting or hoping for. I had me high hopes for these nice looking Diatone quadcopters. But wobbly. Yeah, and that recording was with the digital version here on your right. The 4S analog version had the same wobbles. So on the one hand, that's good. It's consistently wobbly. By now, I've tuned both of these quadcopters pretty much to perfection, I'd say. I will do an update on that with my final tune. I do want to do me some extra test flights. The flights you just saw were last weekend for me, and it's now Thursday. So I've had me some flying time with the quadcopters, even though the weather's been horrible. Both of these fly well by now. So I'm happy to say that I will have a good tune for these L5s from Diatone. So that's nice. And the other thing that's nice is that on both of these quadcopters, the GPS now works. And why is that? Well, let me show you one of the inners of these two quadcopters. It's the same for both. Okay, it turns out to be harder to actually show you than I had anticipated, but over here you see a silvery snake running through the quadcopter, hopefully. Over there, and it runs over here, and it runs underneath the flight controller to over here, I think, to solder bits. So that wire is the wires for the GPS, and it's all insulated. That's why it looks all gray silvery. It's well, it's got an insulation layer around it, and so that helps, I guess, to make the GPS system work. Also, you might have noticed that a lot of manufacturers or companies, RC companies, now have an all-in-one F7 board, which is what this is as well. And that makes UARTs available. With the previous versions of all these all-in-one boards, the F4 boards, we didn't have enough UARTs basically for, well, a proper receiver with telemetry and maybe the DJI setup and GPS. We saw quadcopters with a soft serial, and I'm not sure if that was the actual reason for the GPS not really working well on a lot of these quadcopters. Maybe it was partially the reason. Or maybe these newer boards simply have better power management, better insulation, whatever. I don't know. I just know it now works on both this analog version and the digital version. There is a minute difference. Maybe it's just the weather, but it seemed like the digital version was a little bit faster in picking up satellites, but I'm not sure. Maybe again, it was simply the weather or whatever. Again, it now works. And I must add that I don't really need or use a GPS, but it's nice. It's nice to see your speed or your distance and such. And if you do want the fail-safe capabilities with GPS, it is definitely it might give you a more secure feeling when flying further away, right? So it's definitely useful. It can be useful. And with that all said and done, I keep on forgetting to mention the actual star of the show. These motors, the 2004 motors, they look absolutely gorgeous. Yeah, British Racing Green, well, maybe a little lighter than British Racing Green, with gold accents. Gorgeous! They are actually gorgeous. So these are again their new Toka motors, Unibel motors. And we hadn't seen this size before. 2004, popular motor size by now. And yeah, they look absolutely gorgeous and they fly well. I've done me well 12 flights with this analog version by now. The quadcopter flies well on these quadcopters. More power than I had anticipated, especially grunt down low in the throttle range. Very, very nice. And they seem to be a good combination with these three-bladed propellers. I'm actually happy that Daito went for three-bladed propellers and not two blades for efficiency. This adds some actual speed and agility to the quadcopter as well, if you'd want that. So yeah, if you want to set this quadcopter up for even more efficiency, longer flight times, you could opt for two-bladed propellers, but it flies well on these gem fans. So I think it's a good combination. So guys, that was a first look at the Ditone Roma L5, their new 5-inch lightweight endurance long-range quadcopters, both digital and analog, and both 6S and 4S. Long story short, I recommend them, and they are quickly becoming my favorite quadcopters. Right now, or before I got these quadcopters, the F4, so their smaller brother, if you will, was my favorite quadcopter, and these, very, very nice. They are more agile than I had expected. I'm not sure what the best flight time or the longest flight time with these quadcopters will be. I haven't tried that, but I'm happy to say that they are fun to fly as well. Actual performance. And yeah, I'm happy to also say that they can be tuned apparently. So in my next video about these quadcopters, I'll show you the tune I ended up with. And that'll be for an 850 to approximately 1050 6S or a 1300 4S. Later on, I'll try the 4S version with a lithium ion pack, and I'll probably do a separate tune for that, if it requires a separate tune, that is. Be on the lookout for that. Again, in a couple of days, I'll show you a tune for the 6S version and the 4S version. Until then, if you are left with questions, hit me up, comment down below. Catch you on the next video. Bye bye.
Oops. 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 Oops.